I was in a field in Wales on holiday, and I got a Twitter handle at Brierley_Hill, and someone tweeted, "Never hear the bells of St. Michael's anymore." And I just thought that would be a really nice activity to take up and something I could contribute to the community, thinking it was all dead easy. So that's something else I've learned. And we literally knew nothing about bell ringing.
How was that, Tim?
It's just a bell.
Welcome back to Look Up Brierley Hill, and this week we've been listening to the bells on a Friday night and on a Sunday morning, the bells from St Michael's Churchyard beaming out all over Brierley Hill, and I know you all love them out there in Radioland.
It is so nice when you hear them now, because it brings back all the memories from when you was a kid, your nan dressing up in a Sunday best and all that and going to church, people were getting together. Bringing people together. It's like a call of calling someone in, really.
Every Sunday morning, I wake up to the sound of beautiful bells ringing in the background. And I usually go and see my, this is my daughter, I usually go and see my daughter and my grandchildren every Sunday morning. I walk out the house and I hear the birds singing, the bells ringing, and I just feel tranquil. It's lovely.
If you ask people, what's Brierley Hill famous for? They would say it's market. Until I come along and wreck it. There you go. I think the market, as much as anywhere, helps to bring people together, and it does give the town a sense of identity. While we're here, this is the Moor Centre, and it's the home of the former Marsh and Baxter Works. So you just wouldn't recognise it. This is taken from one of their famous adverts, and there was a really ironic slogan, which was drawing his own conclusion as Marsh and Baxter's, this pig pulling his sausages along. Morning, Katie. Well, I was elected here in 1983, and I said I wanted to make a difference to the town for a better Brierley Hill. And when I finished, I wanted to carry on that work. I'm very proud of the learners that we've brought on. Been a really positive activity and a positive event for the town when we started it all up. And here we are in the ringing room. I'll just turn that off. So if you want to come on in, I will show you some of the things in the ringing room. Clearly we've got the ropes, which will be ringing tonight for practice and on Sunday. And around the wall, you see things we call peal boards. And a peal is a very special piece of music where over 5,000 different orders of the bells are rang without ever repeating one. One of the issues we face is these bells are the loudest acoustic instrument in Brierley Hill. So what we were hoping to do was install a simulator so that we could have what we call a quiet practice. Tie one end over the clapper, pull the clapper to the side, and then it's muscle work to stretch it big enough to stretch along the top of the bell so it just keeps that clapper in place and stops it making a noise. Do you want to film me going down and closing the hatch? See, I'm getting all this imaginative, creative stuff. So I'm ringing the number two. So if you count, one, two, three, a bit late. So those are the two ways that we can use it. One for a silent practice and two for a practice with other perfect ringers around you, so you don't need a whole band. And I think that's miraculous, I really do. And I'm really grateful to Historic England for funding us, because it's going to accelerate now all the people we can teach.
Mornings I would go to Sunday school. I can still feel myself walking down the road, listening to, I can sort of picture it completely, that scene, and just hearing the bells ringing in the background.
Hello, come in.
I probably was quite musical without really realising it. Right, this is my bassoon in its nice new case, and there's lots of bits. If anybody had told me when I took up the bassoon you'd spend half your time getting the thing out, putting it together, taking it apart and putting it back in, I would have said, right, I'm going to play the piccolo, but I didn't do that. So. Thank you. that's what it sounds like. If you're worried about something or something's happened to ruin your day, you go and ring. You can't think about that. You have to think about what you're doing. You can't think about anything else. I suppose it's sort of like, almost like a form of meditation in a way. Expert bell ringers, they give so much of their time to people learning. And, you know, I don't know how they have the patience sometimes. Because I know when I was learning, I'm sure I tried their patience terribly. And I still do now. I mean, what's really nice to see the young ones, the young bell ringers doing so well. They just soak it up like a sponge. And like within 6 months, they've learned something it's taken you 2 years to learn, you know. I mean, it's staggering.
It gives us a common purpose, and I think that's probably very important, because having two lads that age who are full of energy, it can be chaos.
I'd describe it as, if you want to get blisters, then, you know, you come to the right place.
It's satisfying when you do it right. And it's like a mini challenge-y thingy.
They seem to have got a genuine enthusiasm for it. The way they strike their bells is very mature. It's not, you know, crash, crash, crash.
And these two little 9-year-olds walked in, full of energy and full of life. And they could ring.
I know that George has been doing trebling to grand sir doubles.
And it's got to the level that every time they turn up a practice now, I have to say, and what have you learnt this week, so we can actually get an exercise for them at the appropriate level. I've got no doubt that those two, you know, they're heading for the 12 bell bands. They are really, really good. And it's been a pleasure.
Thank you for listening this week to Look Up Brierley Hill. Don't forget to listen out for those church bells on Sunday morning. Ta-ra a bit.
It's a well off the wall kind of activity as far as most people are concerned, isn't it? Like canals or train spotting. When a whole band rings in the zone, it's a very satisfying thing to be part of that somehow. It's a team effort that works, and I like that.
Look to. Trouble's going. She's gone.
We were really surprised at the reaction that we have got. People saying, oh, I can hear it in my back garden, it's lovely. And that is really, really encouraging, and it motivates you.
I think it's amazing what they do. And I'm glad it's come back after 25 years. Puts a smile on your face, and it's just, you just think of happy times when you hear the church bells.
How they do it, beyond me. How they keep in sync and know what each of us do. We should try it, we should ring the bells.
I always think, how the hell did they shoot up in the air when they're on the bell ring? They're pulling down, and what? I'd love to do that, but I'd want to go in the air, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's jazz. Absolutely, that is jazz.
It's just an enjoyable social thing to do. When I went started bell ringing, I was just interested to do it. I didn't know that was going to happen, that I was going to make all these friends. So that was a bonus. That was a real bonus, that was, yeah.
I think people notice when they've gone, and they certainly notice when they come back. The bells of St Michael's, It is sounding from within their community, for their community.
I always talk about Brierley Hill and say it's like a fighter that's been knocked down, but it always gets back up. And that's what we're doing now. We're getting back up on our feet after the steelworks closed and after Marsh and Baxter's has gone. And we're finding a sense of pride again.